All the photos you're seeing right now have been created with Blender. For a long time, I tried to reach a photorealistic look in my 3D creations, and I have failed many times. But I also learned something along the road, and I will share my 5 best advices for getting the pixels to look more like they have been taken with a camera and not created on a computer. Use depth of field. If you ever used a DSLR camera or a mirrorless camera, you most likely learned something about dialing down the f-stops to get a blurred out background. You can do the exact same thing in the camera settings in Blender. This is one of the steps of creating truly cinematic renders. If you don't adjust the f-stop at all, anything in your scene will look sharp and also fake and unreal. When you select the camera in your scene, you can force it to focus on an object, just like a real camera. And this gives you the option to change the f-stop, and you can get the beautiful blurred out background. Get the light right. Often even amateurs can tell if a photo is fake, simply because something is wrong with the lighting, and maybe they can't point that out exactly, but they just know by instinct. So, if you want to sell your fake 3D render as a real image, you need to nail the lighting. One way is to use HDRIs for your scenes to get believable light. HDRI stands for High Dynamic Range Image, and when set up correctly in Blender, it instantly gives your 3D renders more realistic reflections and natural light. You will especially see a dramatic improvement to scenes in daylight when start using HDRIs. There are several places where you can download them for free, for instance, Polyhaven. Pick the best models and textures. Quality matters when you're trying to create photorealistic renders. The textures need to be great and not too low resolution. It is important that the objects in focus are looking crisp and not pixelated and rubbish. Sometimes it is worth the time buying 3D models that are high quality and use them in your scenes. But of course, if you are great at creating 3D models, you could make them yourself. Just use the best possible textures and make sure your 3D models look realistic. Remember to add imperfections to the models and scenes, like cracks in the asphalt and scratches on surfaces, because the real world is not perfect. Choose cycles for your renders. Sometimes EV is okay, but in most cases, cycles is superior in creating realistic lighting that will make your render pop. Especially shadows and reflections look way better and more real. The render time often goes up with cycles, which can be annoying. I found that if you pick a low sample count and tick the box for denoise, you can achieve decent result even for high resolution renders. Mess up your render. This sounds like a bad idea, but real cameras and lenses produce errors like chromatic aberration. It is the funny blue fringing around the edges of an object. You won't get the mistakes with Blender unless you create them artificially. In the compositing menu, you can choose to add lens dispersion to your rendered image. But be careful, you can easily destroy an image if you use the effect aggressively and it looks even more fake. Try adjusting the amount of lens dispersion until you reach a point that improves the photorealism. I hope you can use some of the tips for improving your renders and make them look more photorealistic. Also, check out some of my other videos for more examples on how to create better looking renders. Happy blending!